I'd like to thank everyone for coming this morning. As you know, I'm a fairly new member of the Legion, so bear with me. However, I did work with Dick Zone for 6 or 7 years as a councilman on various events, and I got to know him very well. He was very dedicated. Unfortunately, he's not here today. He has a medical condition that he has to have taken care of today. But I just wanted to give you a little bit of history of Dick. He was a Legionnaire for 60 years, an enormous amount of time, and I'm sure he was involved in everything and anything. He was a past commander, as well as the historian in town. Very active, very dedicated. Some people said he never met a microphone that he didn't love. But that's an internal joke. Don't tell him. But so we're celebrating today as the 102nd Armistice Day, which is now called Veterans Day. That name was changed back in 1950 by then President Eisenhower. We are here this morning to honor those residents of Park Ridge that gave their lives serving our country. From World War I, World War II, the Korean, and Vietnam War. Those veterans are all named on the Doughboy statue down at the Veterans Park. It's an honor to be here today in Dick's place. I'm a little nervous, a lot nervous, and I hope everybody understands that we're making this a little abbreviated. Weather conditions are threatening, and of course the virus going around. So at this time I'd like to ask Sergeant Tim Barrett. To call the colors, please. I'd like to introduce the mayor of Park Ridge, Keith Meshagna.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you for inviting me to speak here today. I'm humbled and honored to speak on such an important occasion. Thank you to the Jedh C. Barker Memorial Legion Post 153 for hosting this ceremony, and a special thank you to Dick Bazone and his many years of work making sure our veterans are always remembered. I understand Mr. Bazone is not feeling well today, and my thoughts are with him and his wonderful wife, Dot. Please get well soon. We all know that when someone enlists in the United States Armed Services, they become something bigger than themselves. They become part of a special group of individuals that put country before self. And in doing so, they give up many of the rights that we all enjoy. They do not know where they will be serving. They do not know if they will be serving stateside nor foreign land. They do not know if they will be serving in peacetime or in wartime. They work on behalf of all of us for the greater good, and we are a grateful nation for their service. all military personnel are prepared to stand in harm's way for the country we love, and that is the reason we honor their service and their sacrifice. We are here to thank the extraordinary men and women who fought and died to protect our nation throughout history. We are the home of the free because of the brave. Today we honor all of our veterans, all of them, and we thank them for their service. Korean War veteran Howard William Osterkamp first coined the phrase, "All gave some, but some gave all," when speaking about his fallen comrades. That phrase is often associated with Memorial Day, but is certainly appropriate here today. While all our servicemen and women are prepared to lay down their lives for their country, those that did deserve a special remembrance here today. We will now read the names of those Park Ridge residents that gave the last full measure of devotion to our country.
Edward Abrams.
Martin Castellonia.
Lester McGinnis.
Fred Peisner.
Charles Statler.
Edward Allen.
John Chadwick.
Carl Clayton.
Edward Engeliart.
Miles Emmerich.
Eugene Laurier.
Raymond Mars.
Richard Metris.
Robert Sayers.
Harry Whitney.
Fred Danke.
William Murphy.
Jedh C. Barker.
Charles Bingham.
David Brooks.
Kevin Humphrey.
Thomas Kyle.
Thomas Mallon.
John Howell.
And Paul Paquin.
Please take a moment of silence. Thank you. May God bless our veterans, our servicemen and women, and the United States of America.
He didn't get introduced, but Steve is our commander, and he'll be speaking a little bit later in the program. The Reverend Vincent D. Alagus. No. I guess
that's a tough one for another track.
Will now present invocation. God of compassion, God of dignity and strength, watch over the veterans of the United States in recognition of their loyal service to our nation. Bless them with wholeness and love. Shelter them, heal their wounds, comfort their hearts, grant them peace. God of justice and truth, bless our veterans, these men and women of courage and valor, with a deep and abiding understanding of our profound gratitude for each one of them. Protect them and their families from loneliness and want. Grant them lives of joy and bounty.
May their dedication and honor be remembered as a blessing from generation to generation. Blessed are you, protector and redeemer, our shield and our stronghold. Amen.
Now I'm going to ask Tammy Levinson to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, at this time we're going to have the various groups associated with the Legion here to present wreaths at the memorial. I'm going to ask for Tom Radu. All right, now for the auxiliary, Ann Whitney, the president, and Dean Mackey, vice president. Vinnie Alfano for the Sons of American Legion. And Larry McKenna. Borough officials, Mayor Meshagna, and veteran councilman Rob Metzloff. Okay, now I'm going to ask a very good friend of mine and a member actually of the TV group here in town, Susan Tedesco, to come up, please. Susan is the daughter of a friend of mine who passed away in December. We're going to make it through this. And he was a veteran of the Korean War. Spent a lot of time with radios, and just a gentleman. And I've known Sue for a long time, and she sang at his memorial service, and I had to get her for here. So she's going to lead us in the national anthem.
Beautiful.
At this time, I'm going to ask Al Quackenbush and Councilman Metzdorf to lower the flag to half-mast, please. Sue to come up again to the microphone with us tonight and sing God Bless America.
Thanks, Bob. Before I sing, I just want to take this opportunity to send our thoughts of well wishes and healing to our friend Mr. Dick Bazone, who called me last night and was very heartbroken not to be here today with all of you. He also imparted some knowledge upon me last night, which I would like to share with you, that many years ago, in 1938, our then president asked his friend and composer, Irving Berlin, did he have any music that would uplift the people, bring them unity, make them feel hope? Well, Irving Berlin looked in his archives and said, hey, I planted this song away a long time ago. So he pulled it out of his chest and presented it to Miss Kate Smith. So 82 years ago yesterday, Kate Smith introduced God Bless America to America. I don't sound like Kate Smith, but I do enjoy singing this song, and I hope you will too. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the valleys, to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home sweet home. From the mountains to the valleys, to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet
hard to follow, but we're going to ask the Reverend to come up for benediction.
Gracious Father, you heard us when we cried in our distress. You graciously kept us safe and free. Without you, we can do nothing. We thank you for being good to us as a nation. Thank you for this service of recognition for those in service who deserve our thank you. Now we call upon you again to let your favor be upon our men and women in uniform who have volunteered to stand against evil intent and our destruction. Show favor on them. Show your favor on those who suffer physical and mental wounds in the defense of our freedom. Show your favor on our vets as they age. May they be an example of integrity and patriotism. Let them be peacemakers. Fill them with wisdom and reason. God, we ask you to bless us and keep us. Make your face to shine upon us. Be gracious to us. May you lift us up in your countenance and give us peace. God, in your grace, bless the United States of America and all of our veterans. Amen.
It's kind of hard to see everybody from up here, believe it or not, but I know the chief of police is here this morning, and I thank him for coming here with his men. We appreciate you taking time out of your day and coming over here. Another honored guest here who never misses an event that Dick Bizzone would handle is Dolly Lewis. I don't know if you, for those that don't know her, she's a direct sister, right, of Jed Barker. So, Dolly, thank you for coming, and of course you be good. I don't know if I'm missing anybody. It's hard to see from up here, but if I missed you, not because I did it on purpose. I'd like to thank everyone for coming. It was an honor to be involved in this today. Little spotty here and there, but I think we did okay. Susan did a great job. She covered me for all my mistakes. So thank you for being here. Appreciate it. I believe there's coffee and donuts in the back here. Unfortunately, the building cannot be opened because of the virus issue, but you're all welcome for a cup of coffee and some, I think there's donuts or whatever back there. I haven't been back. Thanks everybody for coming. Have a good day. God bless.